If, for example, he had a burial maybe 2 meters under the snow, he'd be moving a couple meters back down the slope and digging a ramp into that person. So there's room for the snow to move out. And then again, planning for that consideration of where am I going to put this person once I dig them out. And at the same time, so he's moved through, done with the reco, we have our Carta Avalanche dog. And this is a dog that's trained to use scent to go through and sniff out where someone might be buried under the snow. So this might be a person that's not wearing an avalanche, not wearing a transceiver, not wearing a reco, basically has nothing out there. And man, we are just so lucky to have these dogs able to come out here and sniff us out under the snow. So that's what that dog would be doing, and he'd be indicating to the handler. They're an important team. It's the dog and the handler. They work together. And that dog is indicating that there's something down there and going to start digging. And then she'll be calling to the other rescuers to get people in there and shoveling. Dog's really excited. He's definitely smelling something under there. Okay, it looks like they've uncovered something. It's amazing. The dog did a great job, found that right away. The dog's going to be digging down. All right, I'm going to go have a look up there and see what we've found. Alright guys, and thanks to our Carta Avalanche dog. Impressively enough, that dog was on scene right off the bat, which is unlikely to happen in the backcountry. But luckily that dog was here right away today and was able to find our person buried underneath the snow there. So we could give a big round of applause for all the responders and for the avalanche dog here. Yeah, so those avalanche dogs are an amazing tool that we have for being able to find people in the backcountry. But the avalanche dog...